Okay, how was that pull away? You'll have a bit more grip than that on the start, but we need to warm the tyres properly now. Make sure you get some heat into the brakes as well. No rain expected, no rain expected for the time being. Okay, not the best placement there, mate. Let's try and get a good launch as the race starts. Keep an eye on the lights. The start sequence will begin as soon as... our overall capacity. The more charge you hold, the faster that capacity will drop. Battery charge is high, let's use that overtake button a bit more. lap. You can use DRS when you're within 1 second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone. No tyre concerns at the moment, just focus on the driving. Push now. That was a fantastic stop, faster than we were expecting. Look after these tyres now, and we want to finish the race on this compound. are behind by 2.9 seconds. Puts you into P2, second place. Yellow flag. Gap to your teammate behind is 9.4 seconds. gap on the car behind by 5/10 a lap. We'll be right back. car behind is dropping back. We're seeing a gap starting to form. Okay, that's us with 5 laps of fuel remaining. 5 laps of fuel left. Okay, be aware, the grip levels are going to start falling away soon. By 17.7 seconds. Right, we've got enough fuel for 3 more laps.
factory on a pit wall. You've been amazing.
Plenty of action here at Silverstone, a memorable race and an impressive victory. Tell me, Ant, how do you think they were able to deliver such an incredible result today?
I think a large part of the result comes down to temperament. They were able to keep their heads when everyone around them was losing theirs, and that's allowed them to get the best out of the car, to maximise the strategy and to stay out of trouble.
Well, Mercedes are on top form once again after an excellent race weekend. It's great to see them up on that podium once again.